Welcome to Movie World, the place where we only talk movies. I'm Andy Signor. Look, I got to get to this one because I'm angry, okay? I am angry. I am here to review Snake Eyes. And this movie is an abomination to the character Snake Eyes and to Joes everywhere. How dare you, Paramount, throw this garbage together? All of you involved should be ashamed of yourselves to slap that Snake Eyes name on it. And you did the most egregious thing ever. And that's why I'm even more angry at you. And I'm sorry, I got to spoil something. You got to know. I don't think this is a spoiler. This is a warning. If you went in hoping to see more of this, if you went in thinking, you know what? Oh, yeah, there he is in his Snake Eyes gear. Well, get ready, because it's the final shot of the damn movie. They literally show this shot twice in the trailer because they know they got nothing else to sell you on. This is literally the final shot of the movie. And they're selling it to you like it's a Snake Eyes movie. And they're making posters like, this movie looks cool. That's not the movie you're going to get at all. Oh my God, Henry Golding, what were you thinking? Why do actors like this? I liked him in Crazy Rich Asians. I liked him in The Gentleman, the Guy Ritchie film. He was solid. But now he's on my watch list because, dude, how did you not talk to one G.I. Joe fan? How did you get this script and take this opportunity and you think, oh man, I'm so excited to be the lead in this cool IP. What an opportunity. Yeah, cool. And then you've been out there on Twitter hating all the, you know, pushing back on all the haters because there is a dumb thing about the color of his skin. Who has nothing to do with why this movie sucks. Has nothing to do with it. We'll get to why the character Snake Eyes sucks in the movie in a second. The race stuff, oh my God, shut up and get out of here. It has nothing to do with this movie. This movie sucks because Henry Golding, your character sucked. Your character's not Snake Eyes. You're an embarrassment in this movie. And you're so unlikable. Why did you let them write it that way? Why didn't you get a single G.I. Joe fan to look at this script and go, hey, is this actually cool? Should I do this? Are G.I. Joe fans going to dig this? Or should I just go make a cool ninja movie and we should take the name Snake Eyes off of it? You totally should have done the latter. Should totally just made a generic ninja movie and then put it on straight to Paramount Plus, and maybe this wouldn't have been less of a stink on you, because, man, this is a stink. All right, look, it's hard to really talk about this without breaking down a few plot points of the film. So you can tell I'm hot. I'm angry because I'm a G.I. Joe fan. I got all the figures over there, but sadly they broke because the rubber bands, they don't hold up over time. Can you replace the rubber bands? Does anyone know how to replace G.I. Joe? I'd love to get my Snake Eyes and other figures back in shape to put them behind me, but they're so fragile that I don't. But I was always a G.I. Joe fan, not a Transformers guy as much. I didn't dislike Transformers, but I think you can always tell something about somebody, whether they like G.I. Joe, Transformers. But I digress. I was a G.I. Joe fan. Shipwreck, Bazooka. I mean, come on, I could go all day long. So many amazing characters that I loved. Alpine. I mean, anyway, millions of them. I loved collecting them. I loved them all. They were such fun. Roadblock, you know them all. I liked it. I really always loved it. And when the two live action films came around, I just got frustrated because they weren't good either. But at least they were like had the team ups there, right? There was problems with it, but I was like, all right, well, at least they're trying to have more characters. I still don't know why they haven't made a G.I. Joe Transformers thing beyond me that they haven't figured out how to use this property correctly. In fact, why isn't there just a live action Paramount Plus G.I. Joe show? Would have been way better than this nonsense. You could have done a Snake Eyes backstory episode, which would have been way better. You could have gone dark with it. Like an adult theme, like G.I. Joe action series would have been badass for Paramount Plus. But instead, no, all the cool potential. No. We get this movie. Guys, get ready for Snake Eyes and Kenta and Hard Master and I forget her name. Yay. Oh, and then Scarlett's going to show up and she's going to be the coolest part. But she's, you know, she's in a few moments. And when she is, you're like, damn, can we see more of the G.I. Joe movie? No, she's only in there for a little bit. Oh, then let's have Baroness show up. Okay. Because we got to mention Cobra in this. All right. And then that's it. And then get ready for more of these guys. A lot of these guys. And make sure you don't get any of this guy. No. Get ready for this guy. He's going to be what your movie's about. Now, all right. Like I warned you, there's going to be some spoilers here because it's impossible to talk about this without really getting into it. And this movie, Snake Eyes is a villain, guys. They make him an a-hole villain. Like, the whole movie, he's learning his lesson ultimately is what the movie's about, right? It's so obvious the beats that are coming. And I'm sorry, I gotta give up one little plot point that happens sort of midway through the film, which I saw coming a mile away, for the record. But there's this point where the movie starts with Snake Eyes. His father dies. And guys, Snake Eyes gets his name because the killer of his father rolled Snake Eyes on dice before he died. His stupid like a game before he dies. So now that's how he remembers. The kid saw the Snake Eyes. So now Snake Eyes is Snake Eyes. It's so stupid. So stupid. But now that's like his life's mission is to find his father's killer. And so he's a nomad. We don't know much about the father, et cetera. They'll share more later. But anyway, he's on there trying to find. And so he manages to get up with this guy, Kenta. I think this is the one, right? And he becomes like sort of part of his team. And there's a moment where I don't have the other guy. The guy who becomes Storm Shadow. I didn't get his poster, but he's in this too. This guy, Storm Shadow, is working for him. That's just it's so obvious. Sorry. That's the twist at the end too, of like, oh, I'll call me Storm Shadow, because clearly these two guys are gonna have a tussle. Anyway, Snake Eyes saves Storm Shadow's life in that battle against the Kenta and his mob, and Storm Shadow like is so impressed, like, you gave your life to me, I want to let you into my clan and learn about the ninja clan he's part of. And so they let him in. And then the other members of the clan are like, whoa, 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 what are you, hard master? And they're like, what are you doing? Why are you just letting this stranger guy in? He's how do you know we can trust him? How do you know we can trust him? Spoiler alert, clearly you couldn't trust him, because Snake Eyes is working with Kenta to get the clan and to get the revenge, because Kenta has the with identity of Snake Eyes' father. So the whole movie, and this isn't like the end twist. This is like a first act twist. The whole movie, that Snake Eyes is betraying all these characters we're coming to know. He's like, good guys. The whole movie, Snake Eyes is living this double life, total jackass, no loyalty to anybody but himself. And that's the movie. So the whole movie, he's just a scumbag. There's no reason to like him. I didn't feel for him. Henry Golden did not sell it to me at all. I hated Snake Eyes. I understood where it was going. I knew he was going to make the right choice at the end. All the blah, 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 paint by numbers plot points you expect. They make you hate him. And after I left with a couple other critics I was talking with, we were like, who was that? Why would we ever care about this character? It's an embarrassment. So the character himself is just awful, awfully written, awfully portrayed, not likable. And then at the very end of the movie, guys, they justify him getting the suit out of nowhere. And you're like, what? And meanwhile, he just can take it on and off, and he can still talk. I'm like, what the hell character is this? Snake Eyes was so badass because he didn't talk. He was this ninja to sort of, I imagine it was always just the cartoon was like, let's have one character. We don't have to do the mouth movements. It'll be cheaper. But they made him mysterious and cool, and he had his way about him, and it just had the sword, and he had vowed this life of silence, and in some versions he lost his throat and couldn't talk. But there was an opportunity here to do a really dark, like actual samurai story where Snake Eyes makes a choice and regrets it tremendously, and then has to live with that loss, like realizing what he did. He can't forgive himself, so he lives this life of silent solitude and dedication. And that's not what this movie is at all. Instead, this forced ending to justify the character arcs and get them on their way to get to, I guess, another G.I. Joe movie, but still leading with the fact that clearly Snake Eyes has more to learn and do. And I'm like, no, that is the complete opposite of a character I want as Snake Eyes. Snake Eyes, the Ray Park version of the movies was so much better, was said nothing. And even the little snippets they give you in Rise of Cobra, I had so much more connection than I did at any point in this movie, which was this long, drawn-out brothers, and never bought it for a second. None of their motivations, none of their character. It's all nonsense. And then to add it all, you're like, all right, well, maybe the action's good, Andy, right? No. Action's so generic and boring. And they do this thing in the beginning where it starts okay. You're like, all right, this could be cool. And then the cuts are so bad from a martial arts standpoint. I was so disappointed in the way they shot it, the CGI stuff. It just is not good. And then they just overdo it. There's a scene where they're fighting against 20 characters in the beginning of the movie. And then they, of course, win. And then they manage to fight like 10 more rounds of 20 people, where every time I'm like, well, of course, okay, well, I know what's happening. I got bored. I got bored by the fighting. I got bored by the characters. I didn't like any of the characters. The only person I liked was Scarlet, who shows up, played by Samara Weaving, who I think is great. I liked her a lot. I wanted to see more of her. When she shows up in the movie, I was like, finally. It makes no sense. Like, it's this forced G.I. Joe Cobra plot gets thrown into this ninja story because they realize, like, we got to call this a G.I. Joe movie. So what are we going to do? Like, they just didn't. They were doing this. They got lost in their way of the stupid Snake Eyes plot, which was not worthy and not done deftly enough or, like, professionally enough to really make it, like, hit like a good drama. No, it's still like trying to be a popcorn movie. And so they have to throw in more G.I. Joe elements to, like, distract everybody and make them think that's part of it. So when she showed up, I was like, yeah, cool. Give me more of this. But Snake Eyes, I never want to see him in this movie again. I dislike the character that much. I'm so offended that they ruined one of my favorite characters by making him a jerk, making him boring. There's just nothing likable about the guy at all. Nothing. Oh, my God, I'm so annoyed by this movie. I expected it to be like, eh, but I didn't expect it to be so just mad at the material, disrespecting the source material. And I see Henry Golden out there, like, trying to defend it, but he's all distracted on people think I shouldn't be, a white guy played it. Oh, my God. Anybody who's making that argument, you're ruining things because it doesn't freaking matter. The movie sucks for clear reasons that have nothing to do with what race Henry Golden is. And when we get so distracted on that before the movie's even out, then we do look stupid because criticize this movie for what it actually is, which is awful. Bad martial arts, bad character art, terrible script. Those are the reasons this movie sucked. And he'll never learn anything because he'll label me and anyone who criticizes the movie as, oh, racist haters, oh, blah, 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 blah. It's so frustrating, the distractions we do. I'm so sick of that shit. This movie's awful for very clear reasons, and especially to G.I. Joe fans. Now, are there ones out there that might just be like, I don't care about G.I. Joe. I just want to watch, like, sort of a average, normal ninja movie. I guess maybe you'll be satisfied. But so much potential with this series, and I'm so disappointed with where it went. So damn frustrating. And again, this idea of, like, him holding the helmet. F you, marketing department. You knew what the movie was. You were so desperate to tease the helmet and show us, like, him in action as Snake Eyes that you just lied. You just lied because you knew you had a stinker on your hands. And it makes me even more mad at why I'm being a little bit more vicious. Give me an honest critique. I mean, expectation of what to go in for. Don't you dare show me that helmet. That helmet was a surprise little moment at the end that you've put all over the posters and trailers. And for that reason, you made me even more angry at it when they cut to that at the end. So I cannot recommend this film at all. So disappointed in it. So frustrating. Henry Golden, you deserved better. I can't believe you didn't know this was going to be such a cluster to the character and to the franchise. Don't call it Snake Eyes if you want to make a Snake Eyes movie. Oh, Andy, oh, you're just nerd. What you worrying about your G.I. Joe? Yeah, it's called Snake Eyes G.I. Joe Origins. And you just completely turned me off from any future movies. So well done, team. Oh, so frustrated. All they make is IP now. And then when they have good IP, they waste it. They don't even take, they're like, oh, we can only make movies that are based on things that are popular. Great. Henry Golden, he's popular. G.I. Joe. Oh, Snake Eyes, he can play Snake Eyes. Great. But Snake Eyes doesn't talk. Well, so what? Let's just put him in. We'll learn the origin of him. Great. And then we'll throw some other G.I. Joe. Yeah, but do we have a good script? Who cares? Put it out there. That's literally what this feels like. It's literally what this feels like, and I'm so over it. Well, what do you guys think? Are you excited for it? If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Smash the bell for all alerts here on Movie World, and the like button and your comments down below. Pardon my rant, but man, it was long overdue. Man, I really didn't like that movie. Are you still going to give it a shot? Are you mad I said too much? Did you expect what I told you? Tell me all that down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for more reviews and movie cool stuff here on Movie World.